Thank you, everyone. So my name is Nicolas Brousse. I'm in charge of the operation engineering team at TubeMogul. And I'm going to talk about moving large workloads from a public cloud to an OpenStack private cloud. So is it really worth it? In this time where the industry talk a lot about moving everything to Amazon, why would we want to move out of a public cloud? Why do we want to do that? And does it make sense? What kind of effort is required? I will tell you a little bit of some of the challenge we faced and where we are at today, and kind of learn lesson and feedback on this. As a full disclaimer first, since we are a public company, I have to give some cautionary notes. You won't see any cat picture in this presentation. I hope it's not too disturbing. Anyway, so who are we? An enterprise software company for digital branding. Basically, we build software to help brands to promote their commercial message and all their messaging to their customer. It does mean like any kind of messaging. The biggest one is like through video advertisement, and we try to help them to target the right customer at a good feedback loop on who saw their ads and how efficient was it. But we do that for the whole industry, so not just like for desktop video or YouTube or any platform like that. We do that for mobile, we do that for TV, we call that programmatic TV. We try to be like media agnostic in the way we help the brand passing their message. So what does it mean in number? Last year we filtered over like 12.6 trillion ad auctions in 2015. We served over 3 billion ad impressions on linear TV via our programmatic TV solution. So that's just the TV part of the system. That's huge. You can imagine like what it means with like all desktop and mobile inventory too. All this process works with bids. It's really like a real-time bidding process, like a stock auction or something like that. But it's for ads instead of stocks. And all our bids has to be processed in less than 50 milliseconds. We serve those bids in less than 80 milliseconds. This includes network on trip. You can imagine, given the volume and this network constraint, some of the technical challenge we may have to face. And we serve over 5 petabytes of monthly video traffic. Most of our video traffic is not actually served by yourself. So this is just what we serve. So who I represent today is a team of operation engineers who build this private cloud solution, and I will tell them their story. The team is comprised of SRE, SEs, and DBA. We ensure the smooth day-to-day operation of the platform infrastructure. We provide a cost-effective and cutting-edge infrastructure. That's where probably all this private cloud solution discussion came in. We try to improve all our platform and how we serve it. We currently manage over 2,500 servers, virtual and physical, and it keeps growing. One of the challenges is how diverse is the platform. We have like pop location in many places in the globe. Just because our business is global, we have to serve ads and be on multiple RTB exchange, which forces us to be in a strategic location. And at a very high level overview, this is what the platform look like, what are the different touch points, and what I'm going to focus on is this blue layer, which is this real-time bidding platform, which represents like very high volume of data, very high volume of traffic, small packets, and low latency. This is about like 40 billion HTTP requests a day, to give you a better idea. Our team is definitely a technology orders. We have like a ton of different technologies. We from Java to a multiple MySQL version to a multiple NoSQL solution to all the streaming solution, all the caching solution, all those tools. The engineering team at TubeMogul is about 150 plus people, and we have a ton of technologies. So it does raise a question like why would we try to add another one like OpenStack or some like private cloud solution when we already have like a lot to do. So our challenge on a public cloud. So that's really the high volume and low latency that make our proximity to partners really matter. Being far from those bidding exchange can impact our business and how we win those auction. The huge data set. We have to serve like thousands of different ads and make decisions on those ads at every second. So when you go on a website, we need to know like which ad to select and which one will have the best impact. This is not a trivial process, and we have to have like a very big data store and solutions that are very customized for what we are trying to do here. This is kind of technologies that end up costing a lot very quickly. And even reserved capacity in public cloud solution doesn't necessarily give you much. One other big limitation is like packet per second. That's something when you start to do like very big volumes in any cloud solution today, we have tried or work with those cloud provider. The packet per second has been like a big limitation. Which force you to have like very large footprint and sometimes like makes things a little more complex that you can manage or you'd like to have, especially for load balancer solution. Random network disruption with no root cause has been like a big pain. I know everyone wants to design for their system for to be resilient for failures. It's never perfect, and you always have like some system who are not necessarily resilient. So how do you deal with that, and how you try to improve your system when you don't know like what happened, where your packet went or didn't go, why suddenly you lose like all traffic in a full region? This is kind of stuff we needed to understand better. So our strategy was very simple. That was to go in-house in four locations on three continents. In less than 6 months using a ready-to-go cloud solution and two part-time engineers, then go celebrate in Vegas. Easy. That's something we really thought, or I really thought we will be doing. So it took 3 years. That was the first misunderstanding. If you are hoping to do like a private cloud solution quickly, you will see I will talk about some of the challenges we faced, but it's not that trivial. There is no ready-to-go cloud solution. That's just a dream. We ended up using OpenStack and bare metal, a mix of bare metal solution. That was necessary for what we were trying to accomplish. And we had to have like three dedicated engineers full-time on this project. That's still not bad. We are at this point right now. I will go more in detail. We haven't celebrated in Vegas yet, but we try to keep it up and running, and we are very happy about that right now. So, tissue analysis, that's the things you will start if you want to build your private cloud solution or move out from a public cloud solution. If you have built your whole infrastructure on a public cloud, you have to make sure that when you move in-house, you know what you are doing and what will be the cost impact. So which infrastructure is being moved is an important point. Like, are you moving all your workload out of a public cloud or just a specific part of this workload? How do you compare apples to apples? Like, is like six core at 2.3 gigahertz on your cloud provider is really the same as the one you are going to have? Have you think about like all the challenge about like having a bare metal server with NUMA instead of like your VMs that you don't have like necessary control over these kind of things? What kind of VM do you run? Do you have like huge massive VM with like lot of memory? Or are you intensive? What will be the impact? Do you plan to overcommit? This can really like trick the numbers, so you can feel like overconfident that you can do like a private cloud for way cheaper. If you plan to overcommit, there is a lot of talk about like some public cloud provider will overcommit their instance, so you may have like CPU steal or things like that. You need to understand what you are going into and what you are going to build. Do you cost properly for engineering resources, software maintenance, and various support? That's things that are easy to overlook. And do you make trade-off on your design? Are you designing like really for the same high availability that your cloud provider is going to provide? That question you need to ask yourself before getting into numbers. Otherwise, all your numbers will be wrong. Do you plan for a test environment and all the R&D resources that you need to dedicate for this? And are you actually using your public cloud provider at its best? Are you really sure that what you are doing is really the limit of what you can get? Because maybe the effort would be better spent in trying to fix what you are doing in public cloud than trying to build your private cloud. It's a very important question. Are you actually trying to build a public cloud solution that will be like competitive to someone else, or are you trying to optimize specifically for your environment? Do you plan for growth, or does growth will impact your cost model? How is it going to scale over time? Because maybe today it will make sense, but maybe in a year or 2 years, or depending on how you can finance with your public cloud, this model doesn't make sense anymore. Which location are you deploying is also an important factor. The cost of utility is not the same everywhere in the world, and you have to consider that. So there is three simple rules. Be fair, challenge your public cloud partners. We did talk with all our public cloud partners. We show them our TCO analysis. We talk about it. We work with them for a long time to try to challenge like what was not working, how we can fix them. We didn't go alone on that. We keep it simple. When you start your discussion and talk about your global infrastructure and try to make a TCO analysis with everything, it's become an endless discussion with like opportunity to argue on every numbers. It's very important to keep the problem simple and focus on the key areas that you are trying to optimize. Make very clear assumptions. Have a defined list of feature sets on what you are building. It's very different to try to build a competitive solution from any other public cloud provider or trying to just build the compute unit cloud solution that you need for your workload. How did we start? So we started 3 years ago. We built a small test environment with Eucalyptus to move our integration environment on it. Obviously, it didn't work, so we started again. We built a test lab environment with a vendor using CloudStack to move our integration environment on it. Well, forget it, didn't work either. We finally built a test lab environment on first data center location ourselves using like OpenStack on Gen 2. And shared the lab for our software engineers' integration environment. So as we were in the learning process of all the cloud technology and what we were willing to use or not, we went on our own building what we think makes sense. We use the team expertise at working in data center to build and buy the hardware we thought would make sense with our knowledge of the application. It didn't go that well, so we had like a bunch of failures. We had to stop the project at one point. The big lesson is and the big mistake we did, as we are a startup still and moving very scrappy sometimes. The big mistake was to share our lab environment as the integration environment for the developers. That means that if you screwed your lab, you have like 150 engineers coming to you saying they can't work. That's not a very good, pleasant situation to be in. So don't share your lab. If you build a private cloud or if you plan to do it, you need to have like your own test environment because you will break it. Don't mess up your block storage strategy. Moving to OpenStack, the block storage strategy is very important. You need to understand where are going to be your I/O, what you are going to select, and what kind of workload you should expect. A last-minute change will screw all your setup. Starting a first data center location may require a lot of paperwork, time, executive approval, and hardware mistakes. If you are used to work with data center or bare metal, it's probably easier. if you come from a culture where everything was on public cloud, that will be a big gap, and there will be a lot of education and discussions that need to happen. So you have to plan ahead and educate people. OpenStack is complex. Don't try to make it more complex. We had a couple of mistakes we did, trying to make like way too many public cloud compatibility on the API, too many high availability design or things like that. Trying to run it on Gentoo was also like a big mistake. It's not something that is fully supported or deployed, at least at the time. So there was a couple of things that just take more of our time and our effort where we didn't need to spend. So how did we reboot the project? At one point, like when things settled a little bit, we did reboot the project because we still felt like there was technical problem we didn't solve and we couldn't still solve with our public cloud provider. We worked with them trying to solve it, couldn't solve it. So we had to reboot the project to figure out some solution. So we called again a vendor using OpenStack on Ubuntu. And the goal was to move our Qt environment into one region and move it out from the public cloud and see how it works and hopefully everything goes fine and we move the production environment to it. Well, it didn't work, so we reboot again. We ended up like working on our own again, but with all the lessons learned from like working with vendor, from trying to build this cloud environment ourselves. We simplified a lot our setup. We tried to use like known packages or solutions that were shared by the community and try to be a bit more engaged on that and contribute and understand better what we did. We had a lot of talks with people who are actively contributing to the OpenStack project. That was very important in our learning experience. And we ended up moving our production environment into one region. So we finally did it last year. What that means is that we have our first traffic switch that went smoothly last year. We decreased our footprint in this region by 40% and our load balancer footprint by 95%. Progressive traffic migration is not easy. Consider the impact of multiple environments to maintain and all the application dependencies. There was a lot of things we had to discover, a lot of unknown. It was not an easy move. It did take time from the operation team, but also the engineering team, software engineering team, to support and maintain this multiple environment and how the application would behave like with multiple, with the traffic split between like two data centers. Our load balancer and core data service at the end run on bare metal. We had the same issues at on our public cloud provider with packet per second limitation. So the end result was like running on bare metal and trying to leverage VLANs. So we had like the good of both worlds between like the ease of managing and operating your cloud with OpenStack and also like managing like bare metal for like key systems that require like specific performance. We fully automated our bare metal and OpenStack provisioning. We have a full workflow. Like tomorrow, if we lose this data center, we are able to rebuild it from scratch easily with just like pushing like two buttons on Jenkins. The full deployment is like automated from like a PXE deployment to like the OpenStack configuration. We leverage a lot of Jenkins, Puppet, and some homemade like API or script. We are deploying three new on-premise locations this quarter. So things are going not that bad. It's been like a painful journey. It's been challenging, but we are getting there. We limit the scope to high volume and low latency infrastructure. That's something that is necessary if we want to be successful. We have like a clear need that we try to address. Lesson learned is OpenStack requires long learning curve and design phase. You need to account for it in terms of cost, of skill set, and time. If you don't think about that, if you think you can do it on your own and that just like reading a few wiki pages online, that won't work. You'll be surprised. We were not building a public cloud. Be very clear on your future set and business case. You don't know your application as well as you think. Be ready to adapt quickly and don't overlook the impact of network traffic that switches from private to public. That was the biggest gotcha we got as we were switching our production load. There was a ton of things we didn't know about how the application behaved. So all the things that may go like to a shared storage or some like other services from this cloud provider, your applications still use them when you move in-house, unless you know they are using them and you try to remove that. But if you don't plan for it, you will end up like trying to build an in-house cloud solution that will have like very huge bandwidth requirement and need on your provider. So if your plan was to move on a different location because the location where your public cloud is, you move to this location, you are still like dealing with like very high latency. So if you move from Singapore to Hong Kong, you may introduce 40 milliseconds in your application, which is just not possible in our case. And you really don't know your application as well as you think. You will have to be willing to deal with like some unexpected issues. One of the common one we had was like with OpenStack was IP contract full table full. We had way more like packet going through public that we thought we will be dealing with. It's how we ended up like using bare metal for some of those key system. And there is way more things like that that you will have to deal with. So is it worth it? Moving in-house led to an estimated 30% cost saving and reduced our server footprint. So improved visibility on our network traffic and our full application stack greatly help us to troubleshoot our system and improve the performance. That's something we needed and we are very excited about it. And third point is really like we had a very strong technical need for it. Cost couldn't be and shouldn't be the only factor driving your decision on that. And that's pretty much it. Any question?
Hey there. Can you kind of give numbers on how large your engineering team was and like what its makeup was, how many were?
So how many people were involved in the project? So it's three people who build the infrastructure and then manage the OpenStack environment. What we did, the big change there was, it, at one point they were part of our standard SRE team who manage the platform and the application. We dedicate those three people to this project. But we still have, like the operation team is today is like 17 people. When we started the project, we were five. And the platform is growing evenly too.
And what were the nature of those three people? Were any of them programmer coder types, or were they all strict?
So three different profiles actually. Two of them were definitely having a development programming experience, but all of them had a data center experience or bare metal experience. That's something that is important because you don't. You have to deal and make decisions on NUMA, on CPU performance or things like that. There is decision you need to understand, like the hardware you are buying, how network works. So it's a little bit more than just programming. Yeah.
Yep. So you mentioned that there was a cost reduction. Can you also talk about reliability impacts as a result of the move?
Yeah. So the change is still... That's a tough one because even on our public cloud, we have our time to measure properly. We are not satisfied with the way we measure like reliability. That's still like a big debate. So the simple approach we use right now, we use a catch point as a third party provider to just tell us like, is our latency good? Is our, are we dropping packet or not? And doing like very basic like that. We have way more consistency, way more, we get rid of all our load balancer issues. So on some of this aspect, we know that we have a win. On some other aspect, we still have our time to qualify that. Any other question? All right. Thank you, everyone.